Good afternoon, everyone. I'm here to give you the presentation on validation and confidence interval estimation for the determination of a height of a person from a CCTV footage using the reverse projection photogrammetry. So here's the contents. Now, the introduction. As we know that the use of video camera CCTV has risen sharply over the past few years, and the approach is important because of the present day requirement validating the method and also knowing the error rate before it is put into practice. So CCTV footage can still be useful to provide the lead about the suspect from his physical features, like height. So this method is generally used when the reference image is recorded by creating the same or maybe the identical circumstances as that of the question. Now, aim and objective. So the aim is to measure the height of a person and also locate the angle at which the person's height can be calculated with the maximum accuracy by using the reverse projection photogrammetry. Now, the question arises, what is reverse projection photogrammetry? Basically, this is the method to estimate height, require resistivity and obtaining footage with a in place of the suspect. Also, it is important to ensure that the same camera is in place with its position and the angle intact. So this is the methodology, how we collected the samples. Two persons who were linked for the study referred to as a subject one. And for the subject one, the height of a subject one is 177 centimeter, and the height of the subject two is 166 centimeter respectively, were asked to stand upright in the pre-marked location in the scene of view. And the below figure shows the indoor location of the subject and the reference. Reference is a pole, and the outdoor location of the subject and the reference. Now, this is the overview. So we used a software called ImageJ software. And ImageJ software has so many plugins, but in our study, we use a superimposed plugin in ImageJ. So now you can see in the figure one, left side showing the person position and right side showing the reference pole, both the position as well as the person position and the reference pole position is same. The angle of both the positions are same. Now, in next figure, you can see line has drawn from bottom to top on reference pole and set the scale on image. So as we already know that the height of the reference pole is 121.4 centimeter. So we just put the value of 121.4 as a known distance and changes the pixel to centimeter. So both the next on the next figure, both the images were superimposed by using the superimpose plugin. So after selecting the height of a reference pole, that line was extended up to the head of a person and measured the height of a person by pressing the control M. Now you can see the height of a person in the fourth figure. Length is 177.013, which is the accurate height of a person for the subject one. As I already said, so these are the result, how we calculated the result. So the height of the subject were determined by using the method described earlier by the three examiners independently. These are the box plot. The box plot are created in the R language. So basically from the top, now you can see height of subject one indoor and the height of the subject one outdoor. In the height of the subject one indoor, you can see there is a large overestimation of the height of a subject one. Many locations indoor were very near to the camera. Large distortion could easily be seen and hence overestimated. So if the indoor and the outdoor observations, now we can see for the estimating the height of a three examination toward the equal value, we combined the mean values of for all the three examiner. So you can see, for the indoor, for the subject one, indoor value is 184.7 centimeter for the examiner one and 181.1 1 centimeter for examiner 2 and 183.2 centimeter for examiner 3. But these are the overestimated heights. Like, for the original height, it's 177. Actual height is 177. So now we applied the same in case of subject 2, then the height of the subject 2, as you already know, is 166 centimeter. So in for indoor values 168.6 and for examiner 1 and 166.5.3 for the examiner 2. So these are the indoor observation are slightly overestimating and the outdoor observation underestimating the height of the subject 2. As you can see in the left side of the box plot, for the examiner 2, the accuracy of height is very good. So second, the reason behind is why the examiner 2 has an accuracy. I mean, second examiner is close to the actual height as he had practiced a lot with a sample and has practically more experience than the other examiners. So in the above discussion, if the now we can conclude, if the camera is less than 2 meter to the person, there is a large overestimation. The reason, there is so many reasons behind is overestimation. This was small for the outdoor camera as the closest point of the camera was at least 3 meter. So now we decided to omit the closest point. After omitting the closest point, our examiner examined the whole procedure again. And we concluded that is combined value for the examiner one is 175. 175.6 for examiner 2 is 176.4 and the examiner 3 is 178.9, which is closer to the actual value of the subject 1. Also, similar observations were made in subject 2. The combined value is 165.3 and examiner 2 164.3 and the examiner 3 is 166.8. Means this is the actual value of the subject 2. Now we conclude. There is a overestimation, as we know. There is an overestimation of height at point close to the camera and a tendency for underestimating at far away from the camera. So if the distance of the subject is reasonably far away from the camera along the line of the axis of the camera, the height estimate tend to be accurate. So we concluded that in our study, the distance more than 3 meters were found reasonable. So these are the future directions. We created a deep learning based model in which you just need to put the value of a reference height and it automatically give you the estimation of a height. So in this case, this chair, as you show in this chair, the height of this chair is 108 centimeter. And the person height, the deep learning model automatically calculated the person height, that is 166.2 centimeter. So this is my future direction. Actually, I already created the deep learning model for this. And these are the references. Thank you so much.